All right, guys. So we back with the progressive metal tournament,
finals.
Keeping it rolling.
Finals,
keeping
baby.
It rolling.
Yeah.
So we got Opeth versus Tool. So we did the Opeth video. Check that out.
Opeth Deliverance is what we did, and we're now doing Tool Schism. So it's Opeth Deliverance versus Tool Schism for the winner. This is going to determine who the winner of our progressive metal tournament is,
and we will say who we thought won on the third video.
Yes. Now so let me just keep it real.
Yeah.
We just did Opeth Deliverance, and the link to that will be in the description, guys. So check that one out if you're tuning into this one. If you haven't seen it, they came with it. They came with it. I'll say that. We're going to give our breakdown and our analysis in the video after this, when we determine our winner, but. You know, this is going to be an interesting battle, I feel.
I think it's going to be good, man. This is going to be a good final.
Yep.
It's going to be a good final.
All right. So let's get into it. Tool, Schism. An interesting
they're always
set of riffs, and it's still within their format, within their formula, but this is definitely a lot more progressive, I feel. And it says here that this is on a lateralist album, so, and I can see that, because lateralist to me felt more progressive than the song that we did, which was Anima, I believe. Anima,
whatever.
And this one, I can hear, to me, I haven't looked at the comments, but to me this feels like a more advanced Tool in terms of just them perfecting their progressive style.
Very interesting.
Okay, let's keep it going. You know, when this started, but this is grown on me, man.
Yeah.
I think this is actually very creative.
this is one of those times, and I'm glad that we are going to take a day or two before we do the conclusion, because it is very different. It's very, I think it's because George really likes creative things, so I think it's the creative juices.
You do too, man. Don't sell yourself short.
Nah, I'm pretty one-minded. I'm pretty one-sided. I'm pretty like, nah, this is my shit right here. Now I will be open to other things, but I'm pretty jaded when it comes to my own shit, you know, which kind of goes against the unbiasedness, right? But we all strive to be unbiased. But to your point, man, I don't think it sounds bad. It's just interesting to me. So it's going to take a few listens. And that's just the way I am, guys. Some songs I just have to listen to a couple of times.
Yeah, that's fair.
I'm just not like bought into, especially if it's different, if it's out of my comfort zone. I just have to sit with some songs a little longer, you know.
Okay. So let's keep it going.
But I don't think it sounds bad though. It's just different. It's just very different. So
yeah, with songs, we got 2 minutes and 40 seconds, and the song is 6 minutes and 54 seconds. It's saying here, so let's see. Let's see what happens, man, mm-hmm. as we listen to it and as it kind of goes on here. But I will say this though, and I'm gonna maybe touch on his lyrics later on in the song. This man's pen is ridiculous though. Let's keep it going. Dirty right there to me, like that? Man. That was like dirty. That? Yeah, they're going off, man. Specifically getting into the lyrics, though. What were you going to say, man?
No, go ahead.
Okay.
Go
ahead. Getting into the lyrics. When he says, I know the pieces fit because I watched them fall away. Mildewed and smoldering, fundamental differing. Pure intention juxtaposed will set two lovers' souls in motion. This boy's pen? Shout out to Maynard. Man, I think Maynard wrote this, right? I don't know who wrote it, but let's see. Written by Justin Chancellor, Adam Jones, Dana Carey. And Maynard James. So shout out to all the writers involved in this, because I love the writing, and it's very poetic. It says here, and I didn't really know what was going on until it says pure intention juxtaposed will set two lovers' souls in motion, mm-hmm. disintegrating as it goes, testing our communication. So it seems like this song is about a breakdown in communication between two lovers, right? Mm-hmm. Two lovers are at odds with one another. It says we cannot seem to reach an end, crippling our communication.
Right.
But right here in verse 2, it says, I know the pieces fit because I watched them tumble down. No fault, none to blame. It doesn't mean I don't desire to point the finger, blame the other. Watch the temple topple over to bring the pieces back together, rediscover communication. And then, I promise I'm going to get to breaking it down. But it says the poetry that comes from squaring off between encircling is worth it, finding beauty in the dissonance. That was crazy to me. What? Very good writing. So
yeah,
what do I think he's saying there? This is first listen, Tool fans. We haven't listened to this song 20,000 times like you guys. Bear with us here. So squaring off as in you're at odds, you're fighting.
Adversaries.
And you're circling as in you're just as if you're in a ring, like or if an animal is circling its prey, mm-hmm. right? You're at odds, but you're finding beauty in the dissonance. Dissonance meaning the disharmony, right? There isn't harmony. There
separation.
Is separation, right? Mm-hmm. And he says, I know the pieces fit because I watched them tumble down. I know the pieces fit. I know that we work well together. So clearly,
because we got along at one point in time.
Yeah, right? Yeah,
but until we started tumbling down.
Yeah, I watched it tumble down. No fault, mm-hmm. no one to blame. It doesn't mean I don't desire to point the finger, blame the other, watch the temple topple over. So it's interesting. The reason why I like that part, it doesn't mean I don't desire to point the finger, is because I think most people can relate to that. It's like, even if you know that you're a part in why there seems to be a drift in the relationship, I think it's just our nature to want to just point the finger and accept, mm-hmm. instead of accepting our fault and why.
Taking responsibility on your part.
Yeah. Right. And then the dissonance part I thought was interesting to find beauty. There is beauty in the dissonance. Maybe what he means by that is it's natural for human beings
to argue and disagree.
Yep.
And you care about each other. And it brings, you know what I mean? If you argue and you have opposing opinions, because maybe that's what schism means, man.
Yep. I think you might be right, because I'm looking at it now, a split or a division between strongly opposed sections of parties. But there's beauty in that. And I think it just highlights just our human nature. Right. And I think that's dope. Just the writing has really got me. Yeah. This is very, very well written. And let's keep it going. Right. Storming in that was excellent right there. Was insane with those powerful riffs.
But you know what? I might be the anomaly on this, because there's a lot of Tool fans, man.
And I know the pieces fit.
But you know what I feel like, guys? The best analogy I can give you is if you go to a foreign country and someone could be the nicest person in the world, but they're trying to talk to you, but you don't understand what's coming out of their mouth. That's how I feel right now when I'm listening to this song. I mean, I understand that the musicianship is great. It's a hard listen, guys. So that's why I'm glad that I can sit with this for a while. So that way,
I like the honesty. It's just honesty, dude. I love the honesty.
It's difficult. It's difficult for me to, and you know how I am with groove, and it's just hard. It's very. I'm trying to explain it the best way I can. This is very hard, man.
I love the honesty.
It's very hard for me, man.
That fucking just arrangement. In this section, when they went off with the drumming, it was crazy. Let's get back to it.
We'll be right back.
that shit was crazy to me.
That was hard.
I'm a game of brownie. I'm a game of brownie. I love when we not on the same. Sometimes
that's
I like
playlist
that.
To you?
Yeah, playlist really? For me, dude. Yeah, wow. I like this. I really
okay.
like this.
All right.
Yo, they went off to me. I love when we don't necessarily agree if we're not on the same page. I love that, man. I think it's good to have these videos.
Yeah, absolutely.
I think they appreciate that too. I've heard it in the comments where they're like, man, I like when you guys don't necessarily agree. And I completely understand where you're coming from, comparing this
right.
to lateralist and
the pot.
And the pot. Yeah. This is definitely to me a little bit more complex, a little bit more advanced in the prog elements, in my opinion, just off of gut reaction. So this is gonna be interesting.
Yeah, big time, man.
And we're both gonna sit with the songs.
I hear what you like about it.
Yeah.
I love the way that electric guitar sounds, and I love those hard, that boom, boom, that part that you liked. I like the sound of that tone, but I just don't know if I like the way it was composed, though.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So I don't know, man.
It was prog as hell, even within the sort of, and I thought this was actually a little bit heavier than what I'm used to hearing from Tool as well. This one felt heavy, especially towards the end as they were kind of, reaching the climax, I guess, ending the song.
But I'm going to sit with it, though, dude. I'm going to sit with it,
man.
And I'm going to really try, guys. I mean, and I keep saying this, guys, if you watch, there's a current theme in our channel, guys, is you got to challenge yourself. That's what you guys love about us, right? You love that we do that in other genres. We're out of our comfort zone. Do that in other genres, man. So I'm going to do that with this song, guys. I'm gonna really push myself to challenge myself to listen to it and really kind of, even if I never really like the song, but you still want to be able to see the appreciation in the music. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Even if it's not something that you like.
And that's genuine, dude. Like, I know people are going to be able to, there's going to be a decent amount of subs that can understand where you're coming from with this. This is definitely pushing the progressive envelope more so than some of their other progressive metal envelopes, more so than some of the other songs that we've listened to. I'm not talking about Tool's whole catalog.
Right, exactly.
I'm talking about what we've listened to on this channel. Shout out to everybody that voted for that
man.
One. This to me is going to be a very interesting third video.
Yeah.
So be on the lookout for us doing that video where we announce the winner. We're going to sit with these songs, Deliverance by Opeth and Tool Schism, and we'll see what conclusion we come up with. So that's the end of the video. If you guys enjoyed that, please hit the like button. If you haven't subscribed, please subscribe. And also, guys, check out our Patreon channel. We are now offering exclusive content on Patreon.
Yes, sir.
And that's it. I'm George. That's Ryan. Las Vegas.
We out.
We out.